Hello YouTube, this is me Imra, and in this tutorial I'll show you how to download and install SQL Server 2012. So for that you need to download SQL Server Database Engine and Management Studio. So let us begin. First of all, open up your browser and type download SQL Server 2012. Then after you click on the official link, that is the first one, then after go down other page, then after you will see Microsoft SQL Server 2012 Express Edition. And before download, be sure that your computer fulfills all the basic requirements to install this server. For example, your computer may be of 32-bit or 64-bit. You need to check that, and your processor speed and size of storage capacity and size of RAM, you need to check it first. Then after, click on download, and be careful here. If your operating system is of 32-bit, then you have to download the ANU NT86 SQL Server. Otherwise, if your operating system is of 64-bit, the first one, this one, and the Management Studio, this one you need to download these two, and click on next if your operating system is of 64-bit. If your operating system is of 32-bit, then you need to download Management Studio 32-bit and SQL Server Express Edition 32-bit. Here my operating system is of 64-bit, so I'll download for 64-bit operating system, that is SQL Server Database Engine and Management Studio. Then after, click on next. So it will start download now. The Management Studio is of about 600 MB, and that of Database Engine is 140 MB. So it will take some time, just wait for the moment. Okay, the download completes, and you can find it on the download folder. Go to the download folder. Then after click on double click on programs. Here we can find the programs. So first of all, you need to install the database engine. So database engine is the service for storing, processing and securing the data. So let us install this. It will take some time to extract the file. You need to wait for some moment to complete the extraction process. And click on yes. So the setup is started now. Now this is the first time that we are going to install the SQL Server. So this is the installation center of SQL Server 2012 Database Engine. From here we can perform standalone installation of SQL Server, and we can also add any additional features to install instance of the SQL Server. So we want to perform the standalone installation, so click on the first link. It may take some time. So some setup support rules are checked. I have to wait for it. So we have to accept the license agreement. So check this license agreement. Then after you need to check the second one, then click on next. So we need to download this update. So click on next. It may take some time depending on the internet speed. And that's going to be completed now. So the extraction is in progress. Let's wait for some moment. Installation setup is in progress. Finally, the update is completed. Now again, it checks for the setup support files and rules. Then after, we are going to install the database engine, so it should be saved. And this is the location where we are going to install the database engine, so I'll keep this as default. Then click on next. For this you need to have .NET framework installed in your computer. If it is not installed, it will be installed automatically. And about instances, since this is my first installation of SQL Server, I'll choose the default instance. If you have previously installed, you have to proceed with the named instance. Since this is my new installation, so click on the default instance and click on next. If there are any instance available, it will be listed here. Then after, so SQL Server database engine in service account, SQL Server browser, and collision is for setting the default character set, sort order, and case sensitivity of the instance. So let it is as default. Then after, click on next. So this is the important area where we have to provide the authentication type. I'll be using mixed mode authentication, where we have to enter the password in order to log in the SQL Server database engine. Then after, click on next. leave other as it is, then leave the default setting. Then after click on next, and you should not, it is not compulsory that you should check this. Then after click on next, so the installation is in progress. It will take some time, that is it may take up to 10 to 15 minutes. We have to wait for this. So by this we have completed the installation of SQL Server Database Engine. Again we have to install the SQL Server Management Studio also. So click on close. We have successfully installed all these. Now close all these. Then after we have to install the SQL Server Management Studio again. So double click on this. It will take some time to extract the file. And then after click on yes. So the setup is going to process. Then after, this is the installation of SQL Server Management Studio. Now click on New SQL Server Standalone Add-on Installation. Again it will save the setup support rules. When it is passed, we will redirect to the next interface. Again it is seeking for the update. So there is no update available. So click on next. It may take some time. So by default, perform new installation of SQL Server 2012 is selected here, and I'll perform the default setup for here. Then I'll set the license agreement and click on next. So here we are going to install the management tool, so it is checked here. So you have to check this one. Then after click on next. We do not need local DB. Management Studio is sufficient for us. Then after, no need to check this. Click on next. Now it will take some time. So by this we have completed the installation of SQL Server Management tool. Then after click on the close button and close this also. Now let us check whether it is installed properly or not. For that, go to start and search management tools. take some time while it is loading for the first time. Let me connect it with the Windows authentication it first. So it gets connected. Here we can view the database. Yes, you can view the database here. Now let me close it again. Close it and open with the administrator again. Manage the studio. Then after, and provide the SQL Server authentication. Provide the username SA and provide the password that you have used. You have typed earlier. Click on connect. So it works fine. So by this we have successfully installed SQL Server Database Engine and Manager Studio. You can find the versions also from here. So thanks for watching. Hope you like my videos. And please subscribe my channel. Thank you.